It's November 27, just finished a shoot in ACDC Lane, and I thought I'd do a little video of like a street walk of Melbourne, throw it up on YouTube for the memories. Yeah, it's good, the city's coming back to life, and whilst the office workers haven't really started to return back to work yet, there's definitely a lot more people around. As you can see, there's cars going by everywhere. The mask restrictions have been relaxed as well now, so like you don't need to wear a mask if you're outside and not near people. So that's nice, you get to see people's smiling faces and everyone's happy, everyone's in a pretty good mood on the whole. Oh, I got a call from Perth coming, so I'm gonna take that. Hey bro. Welcome back, Melbourne. Walking around the city today was extremely nostalgic, and there was something that really kept popping up for me, and that is the notion that I was very inspired in the early onset of my film career to film cities. I love cities, and coming from a relatively small city, Perth, with a population of around 2 million people and only 200,000 or 300,000 of them living in the downtown area. When I came to Melbourne, it was like the New York City of Australia to me. Now, I know that people might say Sydney's the New York City. However, I feel culturally, weather-wise and everything like that, Melbourne is a bit similar to New York City as opposed to Sydney. And the one thing that has really struck me post-COVID, post-lockdown, is that me being out there filming what you're seeing right now is acceptable in a whole new way. And people looked at me different. They looked at the camera differently. They understood why I was out there filming with a tripod and a camera, just the movement of the city, which evidently makes it so clear how much we took it for granted. How much many people took it for granted. I mean, not everyone took it for granted, but if we're really honest with ourselves, I think a lot of people did. And you know what? That's okay, because the lesson that COVID has taught us is precisely that. The smells stood out to me incredibly. And there were a completely vast ranging set of smells. There were smells from lobbies and hotel rooms with air conditioners pumping out cool air onto the hot, bustling sidewalk. The temperature today was about 33 or 34 degrees, which is about 93 or 94 degrees Fahrenheit. So it was a warm day out there. And people were in shorts, people were in singlets, people were in their summer outfits, and there was a buzz. People were Christmas shopping, people were enjoying the city, people were eating. The outside alfresco areas are just exploding with life now, and to me that represents exactly what a city like Melbourne is all about: adaptation, creation, and evolving and growing into the new chapter. One really prolific thought that I had throughout the lockdown was the amount of opportunity that's going to come out of everything globally. Sure, people have been affected in the most horrible ways, myself included. My whole life has been changed, and my whole life has had challenges this year, from be it financial challenges through to workplace challenges through to personal relationships and friendships. However, that all said and done, the opportunity for new life and a new start is like so obviously clear to me. It might not be to other people, and that's fine. However, I just see this as a changing of the guard. I see it as people that were hanging on to something are being redirected, and people that are wanting to make something for themselves have got an opportunity where markets have corrected, rentals have corrected, and people are looking for something new. People are looking for something positive. People are looking for a fresh start and innovation. And that's the takeaway that I've had since we've come out of lockdown in Melbourne. I'd like you to think about something, regardless who you are, what you do, where you live, how much money you do or don't have. It's a mantra that I've really embraced over the last few years, and this year in particular, I've had to really remove my ego out of my work and say to myself, if you can inspire one person a day, or if you can make one person a day happy, then that's a good day. Instead of focusing on the many thousands of people that are making millions of people happy or inspiring millions of people, I mean, that's wonderful, that's incredible, that's a goal and a dream, but it actually only starts with one person. And if you can make one person happy a day, or inspire one person a day to take a risk or to do something that they never thought they could do, then you have had a successful day. Melbourne, I love you. Thank you for being kind to me. Thank you for embracing me. And this really is only the beginning.